deserts are when we get the hot temperatures. Statistically. And July and August are when we don't have school. You know, there's an idiom, you don't build the church for Easter Sunday. By which they mean, on Easter Sunday, we could have 1,000 people at this church. Okay, but we're not building a church that can accommodate 1,000 people. On the regular Saturday, we get 430. So we're going to build for maybe 500, and we'll either do two services on Easter Sunday, or we'll just figure out how to deal with it for the other 51 Sundays. Maybe Christmas Eve. That would be the same analogy for any other religion, or whatever the days are that people crowd in and interrupt the time they ignore it. It's not just a church analogy. So the analogy would be then you don't air condition for the hottest day of the year. Do you disagree with me on this? Because here's the other problem. Beyond what I think is the practicality of it, we, the taxpayers, can't afford it. Can't afford to put air conditioning into the school. We're already $16 billion, that's $16 billion behind in repairs to the school. That will take over $1,200 for every man, woman, and child in this class. And those repairs are not being done are a problem every single day. And not even the days when school is open, I would say. Because you don't fix problems, what happens? They just get worse and worse. And you get to the point where you'll get, like we have with community housing, you'll have schools where we say, well, we just can't put people in there anymore. And then you've got a completely depreciated asset that isn't any good for you. There's a tremendous amount of mismanagement going on in terms of how they are looking after those facilities. But adding air conditioning to it would be a stupid idea. 872-1020 numbers, if you disagree with me, you can make the case that putting air conditioning is as you have to do it. I'll give you a couple of text messages that I received at 71010. Because of global warming, it will be 30 degrees Celsius in December soon. I'll be defined soon. You mean before the school fell apart from not being repaired? Which is going to happen first. And somebody else wrote, I had to buy my daughter a battery-operated minivan. Okay. That would seem very
interesting. Seems to have a in the studio.
Yeah, exactly. Come on over and borrow it. The thing is, if the little battery-operated fan works, then great. And I would say, before the batteries run out on the fan, we have a day like today. The only days that are really, really hot are centered around primarily when we don't have school. I suppose one thing we could do, if we think that this is always going to happen in the first week of school, let's make some of the times off at Christmas time and in spring, fewer days, and start school later. We could have gone back this week, and then we wouldn't have heard any complaints. Here is Steve from Toronto.
Hey, Gary, how are you?
Doing well.
Good. So I got a buddy who works at Fuel Starbucks. But they actually closed down the drinking fountains in the classrooms, allocated the sink for just hand washing, one drinking station across the school for water bottle service.
The idea of closing down those drinking fountains that they were never very sanitary in the first place?
It is. That's on top of New York.
Yeah.
Everything's falling apart.
Well, I think, closing down the drinking fountain might be a good idea, but then you've got to replace it with a way to get water to the students.
There's one water bottle,
Yeah. Okay. Thanks for your call.
Thanks, Jared.
Yeah, I appreciate that. I mean, I suppose you could also treat a really hot day, if you have to, like a snow day. And just say, well, all right, fine, we're going to announce there's no school today because it's really hot. And you can stay home where hopefully you have air conditioning. And then we're going to add a day in somewhere else. This is kind of an interesting text message. Air conditioning in school is as important to me as transit and bike lanes in Toronto. Big deal. Okay. There's a person who wants to take a lot of money. Let's go to the next one.
have an update to the poisoning story at a BMW dealership in Toronto last week. The latest the newsroom has learned about that is coming up, and we should hear from Doug Ford on the court decision this morning momentarily live as well on News Talk 1010.
Choose to unfollow the crowd, to find your own path, because the road less traveled means a lot more room for driving. At Lexus, we believe in choosing different. So hurry in. With standout offers on a wide range of Lexus vehicles, there's never been a better time to experience the outstanding design and impressive performance of a Lexus.
Lease a 2018 Lexus RX 350 for as low as 1.9% APR with delivery credits of up to $4,000. Visit LexusToronto.ca or your Toronto area Lexus dealer for details.
Hi, I'm Sherry Fab, co-founder of the Fisbus Eye Institute. Have you had your I've had it moment yet? I've had it with glasses, I've had it with contacts, I've had it with cataracts, I've had it with bad night vision, bad reading vision, bad vision, period. Instead, say, I've had it, I've had my vision corrected at Hertz, and it's wonderful. Don't wait. Google high definition vision. Learn about Hertz. Call us for a consultation. There's no charge. Look after yourself.
Hello, Alpine Credit.
In a world where my kitchen needs a renovation.
Excuse me?
At a time when the Alpine Credit guy is my only hope.
I am?
Two men, one renovation. Only he can approve me for a home equity loan.
Aha! Do you own your home?
Yes, I do.
Then you're approved.
Critics are calling it a crime. Don't miss the kitchen renovation thrill ride of a lifetime coming this summer.
Oh, I can't wait.
Alpine Credit. Homeowners get approved. This will be soft as winter.
What I like about you is that you
have the right stuff. Crave TV, Golden Globe winner Jim Carrey.
Every pain needs a name.
Doors and Kidding, a wondrous, surreal, and darkly funny new series.
What do you think this one is called?
From the mind of Oscar winner Michelle Gondry, director of Eternal Sunshine of the Spotless Mind.
I've been trying to find a pattern here to find me. Never take Golden
Globes. Starring Jim Carrey. Streaming Sunday.
This is Toronto's breaking news, traffic and weather, in-depth radio, News Talk 1010, CFRB AM,
an iHeart radio station.
What did you learn on this iHeart radio station today? We were talking about the decision when it comes to the size of Toronto City Council, and 9 a.m. panelist Robert Turner said this throws off everybody's plans.
And part of the calculus, I'm assuming, for most people running is, well, yeah, I want to do this, and I think I have a shot at winning, and here's why. Well, that's where a hand grenade in, well, now all of a sudden everybody has to be in the team.